Now, the second phase of this algorithm uses this table to construct the output order. What we're looking to generate is the list of nodes in order, and we computed this before. We see it over here, 0, 5, 2, 7, 4, 9, 1, 6, 3, 8. And remember, we can get that by using a serial algorithm just to convince ourselves that it's correct. We start at node 0, its successor is 5, the successor to 5 is 2, the successor to 2 is 7, and so on. To generate this answer, each node is going to compute its position in the output list, and we're going to call that position outPause. And then when we're done, we can use that position to scatter the node into its proper location in that output list. So just to understand what outPause is going to look like, we see that node 0 ends up at location 0 in the output list, so outPause better be 0. Node 5 ends up at the first location in the output list, so it's going to get outPause equals 1. Node 2 is next, and then node 7, and so on. So this is what we're trying to compute here. We're trying to compute outPause. So when we start this, all we know is that node 0 is in position 0, so we can fill in that outPause right away. Now that node 0 has calculated where it will end up in the output, we're going to consider it awake, but all the other nodes are asleep. A node is awake if it has filled in its value for outPause, otherwise it's asleep. So now we're going to do several iterations of an algorithm that will eventually wake up all the nodes and calculate their output positions. So on each iteration, we're going to launch n threads, one per element here. But if a thread is asleep, we immediately return from that thread. Only awake threads do any work at all. So for the first iteration, node 0 wants to wake up its successor. So how does it find the successor? Well, it can just look in this plus 1 array to find its immediate successor. And so we can immediately see that's node number 5. So where will node number 5 write its output? That's what we need to fill in here for outPause. It knows that it's coming after node number 0, right here, and it knows that it's coming one hop past node number 0. So we can add these two values together to see that node number 5 will write its output to position number 1 in the output array. And so now we have two nodes that are awake, node 0, node 5. So now both awake nodes are going to wake up another node and help those nodes calculate their output position. So now instead of looking at the immediate successors plus 1, we're going to look at the next line, plus 2. And we're going to use this to find the nodes 2 away from each of our awake nodes. So node 0 is going to wake up node number 2. So node 0 is going to wake up node number 2. And so where does node 2 write its output? Well, it'll be the sum of where node 0 is at output location 0, and we know we're 2 hops away. So when we add those 2 up, we know that node 2 will be written to position number 2. Similarly, node 5 is going to wake up the node that's 2 hops away, in this case, node 7. Where will node 7 write its output? It knows that it'll start from node number 5 at position number 1, and then we'll add 2 hops to that and get position number 3. On the next iteration, we're going to use the next line of the array, the plus 4 array. And each of the 4 awake nodes from output positions 0, 1, 2, and 3 will wake up the node that's 4 hops away. This will allow us to fill in 4 more values into the outPause array. Node 4 will get position number 4. Node 9 gets position 5. Node 1 gets position 6. And node 6 gets position 7. And the final iteration, using the plus 8 array, lets us fill in node 3 as outPause 8 and node 8 as outPause 9. So the final step is to use outPause to scatter the nodes to their destinations. So let's see how that works. We're going to start by looking at the first node, and we know that node 0 is going to end up in output position 0. So we will scatter this 0 to output location 0 and write the 0. The next node number 1, is going to end up in output position 6. The next node 2, will end up directly in output position 2. And so after we do all these scatter operations, we come up with the nodes in the correct order. So as a function of n, how many steps does this take? Square root of n, log n, or n squared.